I wanted to come on and talk about a topic that is heavy on my mind and my heart right now, and it is hair shedding. I wanted to do this video for so long, and I'm finally sitting down and talking to you about hair shedding, my struggles with hair shedding, and what I will be doing and what I am doing to combat hair shedding. Alright guys, so before we even get started, you know the drill. Please consider subscribing to my channel, give me a like, and also comment down below, what are your hair struggles? What are you struggling right now when it comes to your hair care journey? So let me know down below and then comment so we can all, you know, get this conversation started on, you know, what we're all doing on our little healthy hair journeys. So I'm gonna go ahead and get right into this video. Alright guys, so I wanted to start by letting you guys know, if you are not a subscriber to my channel, you haven't followed my channel for a while, I wanted to let you know about my hair personally. So I am natural, but I am a heat trained natural. So I don't wear my hair curly. I choose to straighten my hair using heat. I blow dry my hair every 2 weeks and straighten it with a flat iron every 2 weeks. And in between, I'll wrap my hair every night and I wear my hair straight. That's pretty much how I prefer to wear my hair. I'll curl it, you know, with a curling iron sometimes, but I normally just kind of wear it straight. And I've had my hair super short. I like to cut my hair, but my husband wants me to grow my hair right now, so I'm growing it out. But I've had my hair short in a bob. I've had it super long, like tailbone length. And right now I would say it is probably approaching waist length right now. And I'm gonna continue to let it grow and see how, you know, how long it gets. But as my hair has been growing, I have been suffering from hair shedding, and I want to talk about hair shedding, what it is, the difference between hair shedding, hair breakage. So let's go ahead and get started. So hair shedding is a form of hair loss, and hair loss can be from hair shedding or breakage. Shedding is different from breakage because breakage is actually your hair breaking off mid shaft, you know, at the end, so like split ends, where the split ends are, if it's breaking off there. So any breakage that happens, you know, along your hair strand, not from the root, is just breakage, right? And that could be done from hair damage, from heat, from physical manipulation, which means combing it, you know, pulling it back into a ponytail, the actual, you know, rubber band or hair tie, hair band that you're using, scrunchie, you know, pulling on your hair and breaking it. It can be from that. It can be from chemical damage, so many different things. It's just really the weakening of the hair and it being broken off. So that's breakage, right? But hair shedding is different because it is actually your hair coming out from the root of your hair, right? So the difference is that you can actually, if you look at the hair that's, you know, on the floor in the sink, wherever it is, that's not attached to your head anymore, if you look at it, and I'm sorry, like my cleavage, I'm not about that, so I'm gonna just, you know, get that together. So if you look at the actual hair and there's like a white little bulb at the end of it, that's from your hair, you know, your scalp, and that's hair shedding. Now hair shedding is normal, right? People shed from 50 to 150 hairs a day. That's super normal. But if you are noticing it, like you're, you know, maybe going through your hair and you're noticing lots of hair coming out, you're washing your hair, and as you wash your hair and you detangle your hair, you're noticing a massive amount of hair that's just not normal, that is excessive hair shedding. And that can be from a lot of different things. Most times it's from too much physical manipulation, right? So pulling your hair back in a ponytail, always wearing it in like a bun, is really creating a lot of tension and stress on your scalp. So you can get a lot of hair shedding from that. You can also get it from stress. So stress from, you know, life can really affect your hair shedding. Also your diet can affect how your hair sheds. And then some people also go through seasonal hair shedding. So it's normally between the months of like October, November, but it can be different for different people. You go through excessive shedding in certain months, so it could be like seasonal for some people. Now for me, I'm noticing that my hair is just shedding a lot, and it could be from diet, it could be from stress. I mean, everybody's stressed right now, with what's going on in the world. And there also can be another reason. It could be from an iron deficiency. a lot of women are iron deficient and they don't know it. So I've actually ordered some iron supplements to see if that will help. That's helped a lot of people. But I'm going to talk about what I will be doing other than that, that will help hair shedding, that has helped me in the past. So the first thing you want to do when trying to combat shedding is look at your hair care practices. So look at what you're doing to your hair before you start to think about your treatments and what you're going to do, what you might ingest, what you might put on topically on your hair to help with shedding. Let's look at your hair care practices. Are they healthy? Are you using a wide tooth comb? Are you making sure that you're not creating too much tension on your scalp? I need to kind of look at that because I actually wear my hair in a ponytail a lot. I used to also wear low buns a lot, just because, you know, being stressed at work, I didn't really have time to, you know, do a style in my hair or anything like that, and I would just, you know, put some product in it, slick it down, put it in a very tight low bun, or put a, you know, tight ponytail in my hair and go about my day so I could look put together and, you know, go to work and work. But I need to kind of reevaluate that and maybe not do so many ponytails and buns, and just for right now, so that the tension is off of my scalp, so that I'm not getting so much shedding from that. Because I tell you, when I take that ponytail out, the amount of hair that comes out, and then when I go to wrap my hair at night, the amount of hair that is on my bathroom floor is alarming. It's very scary. So I'm gonna try to look at that. I do use a wide tooth comb. I don't comb my hair with any small combs or anything like that, so I'm good there. And I try to handle my hair very carefully when it's wet, because when your hair is wet, it's the most fragile, so you have to be very, very careful when you are handling your wet hair. So maybe I can be a little bit more careful when my hair is wet. I only really comb my hair when there's conditioner in it when it's wet, so I'll see what else I can do to make sure that I am babying my hair. Other than that, you want to think about your scalp health. Do you have a healthy scalp? I have started using a scalp scrub, and I've really started paying attention to how my scalp looks, how it feels. Do I have dandruff? Do I have, you know, dry scalp happening? Is my scalp itchy or anything like that? So I'm really just paying attention to the health of my scalp, and using a scalp scrub has really, really helped. And also, I've been using the Olaplex number 0 treatment directly on my scalp to strengthen up my hair too. So trying to create a healthy scalp environment. As far as my stress and my diet, the world is going through a lot right now. We're in election year. You know, a lot of people are not working. If you are working, that's stressful, because it's like, you know, you're trying to, I work in luxury retail, and I run a beauty counter. So, you know, trying to make sure that you are meeting goals, and it's different like that. Work is stressful for everyone. Whatever field you work in, it can be really, really stressful. You know, a lot of people got let go from my job, and from, you know, people's jobs that I know, people are looking for jobs. So there's just a lot of stress in the world, right? Economically, you know, the pandemic is stressful, just thinking about it and thinking about, like, trying not to get sick. And it's just a lot of tension, a lot of stress going on. So that can't be helpful for anyone. I'm surprised I have any hair left, you know, due to that sort of stress. But I'm just trying to create healthy practices for myself to de-stress and make sure that my environment, my mind is stress-free, that I'm peaceful, that I'm making sure that, you know, toxic things, people are not really in my life and surrounding my mind. I'm doing exercises to, you know, help to me to be positive and stay motivated and not let the stress get to me mentally, because that can really manifest physically with hair shedding, but not only hair shedding, but with sickness in the body and things like that. Diet, not gonna lie, I actually lost 20 pounds recently, but I gained about 5 back because I went on vacation. I was drinking tons of alcohol, and I only really drink on vacation. So, you know, I was drinking alcohol with my husband and eating everything in sight. So, like, all the desserts, all the, you know, I was in Jamaica, so all of the rice and peas and curry chicken and curry goat and stewed chicken and all of the cornmeal porridge in the morning and bacon and meat and, like, again, alcohol. So you know, and bread. And so my diet right now hasn't been the greatest. And we actually went on another trip. We went to Mexico, and then, you know, tacos and alcohol again. And yeah, wasn't the best for my diet. But now that I'm back, and I've been back for a while, and now that I'm back, I haven't been eating well. I love ice cream. That's like my weakness. And when I'm stressed out and I have a stressful day at work, I'll go get a pint of ice cream. So I need to, you know, get back to eating more healthy and working out, because that will definitely help with this situation. Guys, I know I'm spending a lot of time on like talking about, you know, outside things, but they really affect what's happening, you know, internally. You know, what you put in your body, what you ingest, really, really affects, you know, what manifests, like how your skin is, how your hair is growing, the health of your hair, the shine of your hair. So I'm really gonna be focusing on my diet here soon. So yeah, I also, like I said, ordered some iron supplements, because I want to see if maybe I am iron deficient and that might help. We'll see, it won't hurt. Iron is a really great supplement to take anyway. All right, I want to talk about the two big treatments that a lot of people use for hair shedding: tea rinses and rice water. So rice water is the new buzzword, buzz term, because a lot of people have started to use rice water in hair care, right? A lot of people were using rice water in skincare. Like, that's been for years, years and years. And there's a lot of huge companies who use rice water in their skincare, namely SK-II, which is a huge, like, luxury brand that uses rice water for their skincare. So rice water has been around for a while, but rice water rinses have actually, it's been around for a long time. It's only become recently popular, I think, because that's how, you know, trends that, you know, when something is trendy, everyone learns about it, right? But there's been tons of people who have always done rice water in their hair. Now I want to talk about tea rinse and rice water. I'm going to start with rice water. I don't use rice water, and it's something that I'm going to be trying. And if you guys are interested in me filming a video on how I use rice water in my hair, then I will definitely do that. I'm going to start doing rice water rinses, and there's several ways that you can use rice water, but I want to talk about rice water and why people say that it's really good for hair health. Rice water actually has vitamins B and C, which is really good, but it also has a lot of minerals and trace minerals in it that is, you know, that can be really good for your scalp. So those trace minerals and vitamins B and C can actually help strengthen your hair, strengthen your hair at the scalp, so it can be more resilient to shedding. It also helps with the just overall texture of your hair, so like how shiny it is and the quality of your hair. And then also a lot of people say that rice water helps with just the strength of your hair overall, so that can really help just in general. And then so that's why people use rice water. You can use it three ways. You can just soak the rice in water and then use that water, drain it, obviously use that water, and use it as a rinse after you wash your hair. You could also boil it and use that water that you have boiled, the excess water from the boiled rice. You can use that again after you wash your hair as a rinse. You can also ferment the rice. I don't have time for that. So what you could do is boil or soak it. That water you can put in a cool, dry place and ferment it for like 2 days. Once it starts to smell a little sour, what you're gonna do is like refrigerate it. You can use that. A lot of people do ferment it because they think it's stronger. I wouldn't do that. I probably just boil it and use that water just as a rinse after I wash my hair. So yeah, I'm gonna try that. Let me know if you guys want me to film a video. Now, black tea or green tea rinses people also use, again, because green tea has antioxidants and caffeine, and black tea has caffeine and a few antioxidants as well. And caffeine actually combats, there's something that happens with hair loss, right? There's a cause for it, and caffeine is known to, like, one, stimulate the scalp, so it really helps with growth, but also to combat whatever the chemical is that deals with hair loss. It is known to, like, combat that. I've heard that. But black tea rinses, you can boil a few tea bags and use that in your hair after you wash your hair, and that can help to stop hair shedding and hair loss and also help with hair growth. And then the green tea, some people use green tea instead of the black tea because black tea can dye your hair a little bit. So you can use the black tea rinse after you wash your hair. You can put it in a spray nozzle, spray it on your scalp, spray it throughout your hair. You can put it in a bottle and just like pour it over your hair, and that is really good also for hair shedding. So I've done many years ago a black tea rinse in the past. And so yeah, I just wanted to come on and share a video on, you know, excessive hair loss and what I'll be doing on my part to reduce stress and to, you know, take care of my diet, you know, do supplements. And I will be doing the topical tea rinse and rice water in my hair too. And I will update you on, you know, my hair shedding and whether it has stopped or really reduced. My hair is really thick, so a lot of people don't, you know, understand when I say I, you know, suffer from, you know, excessive hair shedding. They're like, well, your hair is so thick, you don't even notice it. I really do notice it. And I don't want it to get to a point where my hair really, really thins out and it turns into like really bad hair loss. So I'm gonna try to take care of it now. And I hope this video, you know, helped you guys. And I hope you guys are taking care of yourselves, not only just your hair, but yourselves in these trying times. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please don't forget to give me a little like and subscribe to my channel if you are interested in, you know, seeing my other videos that I post. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye, guys.